"I shall keep the belt," said Dorothy.
"But how can you escape without my consent?" asked the King.
"Easily enough," answered the girl. "All we need to do is to walk out the way that we came in."
"Oh, that's all, is it?" sneered the King.
"Well, where is the passage through which you entered this room?"
They all looked around, but could not discover the place, for it had long since been closed. Dorothy, however, would not be dismayed. She waved her hand toward the seemingly solid wall of the cavern and said, "I command the passage to open." Instantly the order was obeyed, the opening appeared, and the passage lay plainly before them. The King was amazed, and all the others overjoyed.
"Why, then, if the belt obeys you, were we unable to discover the Tin Woodman?" asked Ozma.
"I can't imagine," said Dorothy.
"See here, girl," proposed the King eagerly. "Give me the belt, and I will tell you what shape the Tin Woodman was changed into, and then you can easily find him."
Dorothy hesitated, but Billina cried out, "Don't you do it! If the Nome King gets the belt again, he will make every one of us prisoners, for we will be in his power. Only by keeping the belt, Dorothy, will you ever be able to leave this place in safety."
"I think that is true," said the Scarecrow. "But I have another idea, due to my excellent brains. Let Dorothy transform the King into a goose egg unless he agrees to go into the palace and bring out to us the ornament which is our friend Nick Chopper, the Tin Woodman."
"A goose egg?" echoed the horrified King. "How dreadful!"
"Well, a goose egg you will be, unless you go and fetch us the ornament we want," declared Billina with a joyful chuckle.
"You can see for yourself that Dorothy is able to use the magic belt all right," added the Scarecrow. The Nome King thought it over and finally consented, for he did not want to be a goose egg. So he went into the palace to get the ornament, which was the transformation of the Tin Woodman, and they all awaited his return with considerable impatience, for they were anxious to leave this underground cavern and see the sun shine once more. But when the Nome King came back, he brought nothing with him except a puzzled and anxious expression upon his face.
"He's gone," he said. "The Tin Woodman is nowhere in the palace."
"Are you sure?" asked Ozma sternly.
"I'm very sure,"
answered the King tremblingly,
"for I know just what I transformed him into and exactly where he stood, but he is not there. And please don't change me into a goose egg, because I've done the best I could."
They were all silent for a time, and then Dorothy said, "There is no use punishing the Nome King any more, and I'm afraid we'll have to go away without our friend."
"If he is not here, we cannot rescue him," agreed the Scarecrow sadly. "Poor Nick, I wonder what has become of him."
"And he owed me 6 weeks back pay," said one of the generals, wiping the tears from his eyes with his gold-laced coat-sleeve.
Very sorrowfully they determined to return to the upper world without their former companion, and so Ozma gave the order to begin the march through the passage. The army went first, and then the royal family of Ev, and afterward came Dorothy, Ozma, Billina, the Scarecrow, and Tik-Tok.